Let's look at how safety incidents occur to see some basic concepts underlying process safety. First, we'll start with a hazard. A hazard is something that can cause harm, like a poisonous gas or a flammable liquid or a sharp knife. The presence of a hazard creates a potential for an incident, but no incident can occur until something else connects with the hazard. A threat is something that has the potential to connect with the hazard and cause an incident. It could be a person using a knife or a spark that ignites a cloud of flammable gas. The incident results in a consequence, a finger cut, a person burned. An incident typically has multiple consequences. So, here we have the basic elements of a safety incident: the hazard, the threat, and the consequence. Now let's look at a very simple example. Imagine a warehouse with a slick and slippery floor. In itself, the slippery floor causes no harm, but it creates a potential for someone to slip and fall. Enter a worker stepping onto the slippery floor. If that worker should slip and fall, an incident occurs, and what might be the consequence? Maybe a broken arm. Maybe lost production as the warehouse responds to the medical emergency. Maybe the worker will sue the business because they think that floor should not have been slippery in the first place. So the hazard is the slippery floor, the threat is the worker walking, and the consequence are multiple. Now, let's look at a simple process safety incident. Imagine a facility pipeline carrying natural gas, a flammable gas under pressure. The gas always has the potential for explosion if it leaked and if the leak met an ignition source. Enter a worker who lights a cigarette near a leaking valve. The spark ignites the gas and causes an explosion and fire. The consequences may be severe: serious burn injury, serious damage to the facility, and prolonged lost production. Here, the hazard is the gas, the threat is the worker bringing an ignition source, and the consequences are severe. So now, let's look at how we might prevent this incident. One obvious thing we could do is to train the worker not to smoke in the facility. That training is a barrier to prevent the worker from igniting a leaking gas. However, no training is perfect, and all barriers have holes. So maybe that same worker forgets and lights up another cigarette. So we can put in multiple layers of barriers. Let's add signs to remind them and procedural rules to follow. Let's add several more barriers to prevent the leak from occurring in the first place and to prevent any other sources of ignition. This is how we design our process safety systems, with multiple layers of protection to avoid multiple threats. Of course, even our most robust safeguards are never perfectly foolproof. Even with all we do to prevent incidents, a threat can find its way through the holes in our system and can cause an incident, which can have multiple serious consequences. Therefore, we also put in place mitigation controls to mitigate the results of the incident. Maybe we have an on-site medic who can quickly treat injury, and we have effective fire suppression systems, and we have emergency contingency plans. These mitigating controls reduce the severity of the consequences. So, now we have a picture of risk management, showing proactive measures to the left and reactive measures to the right, and the hazards and threats and potential incidents, which are sometimes called top events. We call this picture a bow tie diagram because it looks like a bow tie, and it's a valuable tool used by engineers to analyze specific process safety risks.